Teacher Daisy. Today, I'm going to teach you Exercise Computer Chapter 4.1. I will explain this subject in English and Malay. However, the exam is using Malay, so you need to remember the terms in Malay. Let's start now. In this chapter, you will learn Pemboleh Ubah, Operator Matematik, Struktur Kawalan Pilihan and Ulangan in Atocara. Besides that, we will also learn pembangunan atau cara testing and fixing ralat. First, let us look at kod arahan. Suppose you want to ask your friend to help you do something. You must speak in a language that your friend can understand, right? What about if you want to ask computer to help you do something? You must use a language that computer can understand also. So, kod arahan is an instruction that instructs a computer to perform a specific task. Kod arahan is written in a computer language that can be understood by a computer to instruct the computer to perform a task. A set of kod arahan that instruct a computer to solve a task problem is called atocara or program computer. The examples of atocara are Java, C language, Python. Pemboleh Ubah and Operator Matematik are used in pengatocaraan. We will discuss on them one by one. Pemboleh Ubah. Pemboleh Ubah is a storan ingatan used by a computer program to store data. Data stored in Pemboleh Ubah can be processed. Pemboleh Ubah store data in the form of nilai berangka, teks, dan nilai logik. You can think of the Pemboleh Ubah as boxes. The value can put inside the boxes is based on the bentuk of the box. Nilai berangka, teks, or nilai logik. Inside a nilai berangka box can put integer or nombor perpuluhan. For example, 10.5 or 47. Inside a text box can put one or more abjad, for example, A or bagus. Inside a nilai logic box can put nilai boolean, which is either false or true only. While operator matematik are the symbols used in performing mathematical operations in kod arahan, the symbols of tambah and tolak of operator in computer are the same as maths. But for darab, the operator in computer is asterisk. And for bahagi, the operator in computer is slash. Now, we will learn the way of writing atocara for struktur kawalan pilihan. In the previous chapter, we learned that there are three types of pilihan. Pilihan tunggal, dui pilihan, and pelbagai pilihan. In these three types of pilihan, when we do pengatocaraan, need to remember the way to write. For pilihan tunggal, when we want to write in pengatocaraan, we need to use it. For dui pilihan, when we want to write in pengatocaraan, you need to use if, else. And for pelbagai pilihan, when you want to write in pengatocaraan, you need to use if, else. The figure below shows cata alil pseudocode which involved in pelbagai pilihan. And after turn it into atocara, scratch will be look like this. Next, we will learn the way of writing atocara for struktur kawalan ulangan. Ulangan is a process atocara that will instruct the program to perform an action over and over again until a condition is met. The repetitive actions are called gelong. An example in our daily life that's involved in repetitive behaviors is as below. In a car park, as long as no empty parking lot is found, the driver has to drive his car around the parking lot repeatedly. When the condition is met, in here, is meeting an empty parking lot, then the repetitive action will end. There are some struktur kawalan ulangan blocks in Scratch 2.0. The blocks used for the struktur ulangan are first, forever. Forever gelong the atocara without stopping. Second, repeat. repeats the atocara according to the number of lelaran specified. Third, repeat until. Repeat the atocara until a condition is met. After go through the elements in atocara, it's the time for us to learn the flow of pembangunan atocara. There are 5 fasa for pembangunan atocara. First, analisis masalah. Second, reka bentuk atocara. Third, pengegodan. Fourth, pengujian dan penyiar perbijakan. Fifth, dokumentasi. The details of the 5 fasa is as below. First, analisis masalah. In fasa analisis masalah, we need to conduct interviews with customers to find out what the customer wants. Then, determine input, process, and output. After that, think of possible solutions to the problem. Second, reka bentuk atocara. In this fasa, we write pseudocode, draw carta alir, and design a graphical user interface, GUI. Third, pengegodan. Choose a bahasa pengaturcaraan such as Visual Basic, Java, C++ for program development, and then convert pseudocode and carta alir to computer understood code. Fourth, pengujian dan penyiar perbijakan. In this fasa, we will test the program that has been written, detects any ralat that arise such as ralat syntax, ralat masalarian, and ralat logic, then fix ralat found in code atocara. Fifth, dokumentasi. Provides 2 types of dokumentasi. Dokumentasi dalaman dan dokumentasi luaran. Dokumentasi dalaman is intended to facilitate the penyiar perbijakan of a atocara or system. This is used by other pengaturcara dan pelanggan. Dokumentasi luaran is a user manual that explains how to use the atocara. This is for the pengguna akhir. Let us now move on to the testing and fixing ralat of atocara. First, we need to know what is ralat. Ralat found in the atocara will cause the program to be not able to operate properly and produce incorrect output. Ralat can occur when doing algorithma, writing pseudocode, drawing carta alir, or writing code arahan in atocara. There are 3 types of ralat. First, ralat syntax. Ralat syntax occurs when writing code arahan or pengegodan. Incorrect syntax or format pengegodan used. The information entered in the code arahan cannot be read by a computer. Second, ralat logic. Ralat logic occurs when writing code arahan. The program is able to recognize and execute the code arahan, but give the wrong output. Third, ralat masalarian. Ralat masalarian occurs when a program is being launched. It is caused by the program and not the system operasi. This type of ralat can be caused by perisian hasad, such as virus or cecacing, kepincangan atocara, terpijat, or ingatan yang tidak mencukupi. The steps to test the program and fix ralat are: Step 1, compare the program result with the algorithm, pseudocode or carta alir. Step 2, finding the ralat on code arahan with re-exam the code arahan, which is written in the program through semakan meja, desk check. If you forget what is semakan meja, can go to bug 3 algorithm and read again. Step 3, if found ralat, fix the ralat in the code arahan. And step 4, test running the atocara again. If there are still have ralat, repeat steps 1 to 3.
If you find this video is helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And if you got any question, can comment below. Thanks for watching.